What is good, Mexit planners? If you are a remote worker or digital nomad moving to Merida, Mexico, one critical necessity for working is fast and reliable internet. Merida, Mexico has really fast fiber optic internet in the city. However, as the city expands faster than the telecommunications infrastructure, many folks that move out to the new surrounding developments discover that the options for suitable internet is very limited. I've worked with many clients who've paid several deposits and moved into a new place only to discover that they couldn't work from their new home because of the internet service. So what does a person do in that scenario? Well, thankfully, there is now an out-of-this-world option that can provide service to anywhere in Mexico. I'm talking about the Starlink satellite service from SpaceX. So today I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up a Starlink system, recommend a few additional items that you might want to add to your Starlink setup, and demonstrate how you can make the Starlink system located anywhere in the world appear to be from a US location. Get ready to nerd out with me. Let's get it. All right, Mexit planners. So what I want to do is show you how the Starlink comes to you here in Mexico. So I'm gonna flip the camera around here. So here you can see I have a box from Starlink, and this is actually a replacement. The satellite that I originally had some problems, and it was one that I bought secondhand, and I actually reached out to Starlink via their support email, and they were kind enough to replace it. But this is the size of the box. It is probably, this box is maybe 18 inches wide by 12 inches deep and 12 inches long. But this is what you get when you get the kit. So this is their standard kit. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and unbox it. So when you open it up, you have your satellite, you have your stand. So this is the stand that the satellite actually sits on. This is the sat. So there's the satellite, and it just plugs in here. So let me zoom back so you can see that. It's kind of hard to see, but that is the satellite there. This satellite is fairly small and it just fits into the base here. So we're gonna plug that in just a second. But in the box, you also get their router, which we'll talk about more in detail. So this is the Starlink router, and you get a power cable. So this is the power cable. Now, in this really, really long cable that you see here, this is what connects the router to the satellite. So if you're running this permanently, you're gonna wanna drill a hole in your wall here in Mexico, which may take some specialized tools. But if you're running this in a permanent installation, then this is gonna need to go through a wall and inside, and they actually make an installation kit. I don't have the installation kit because this is a backup satellite for me, so it's not my permanent internet, but it's something that I use if my Telmex internet goes out, which it did a few weeks ago, and I tried to use my satellite, and of course I was having some issues. So that's when I had to call the RMA replacement, and it came within like 7 days, which was nice. All right, so that's the unboxing of the Starlink. Next, let's go ahead and get this thing set up in an area where there are no obstructions. So the area that I am in right now, if you look up, I'm in my garden. There's this gigantic tree that's above us that provides lots of shade and canopy, but I'm gonna try to set it up in the yard once my sprinklers go off. And if that doesn't work, I have another place that I know works really well, and that's on top of my casita back there behind the pool. So we'll cut to that, and I'll catch up with you in a bit. All right, Mexit planners. So I have the satellite set up over there in front of my pool. I'll step out on this back patio, the second patio, and I'm just running into the room where all of my communication equipment is located. So all of my networking equipment. But I want to show you, I'm just going to try it here first. The most important thing is no obstructions with this satellite. And so I'm not sure if this big old tree over here is going to provide obstructions or not, but for the sake of this demo, I think it'll be okay. I showed you that the satellite, so you have this long cable that runs basically from the sat into the router. And the router is where it gets power and everything. So that is super important. And so we're gonna just go back here into this room where I have run the cable, and we're gonna plug in. But one of the things I wanna tell you about the equipment that comes with it. So by default, you would simply just plug in your Starlink here to the bottom of the router, right, to the cable, and then it would receive its power. But one of the things that I think is severely missing from this as a default installation is an Ethernet port. So there's a separate adapter that you can buy, which is this Ethernet kit, which I highly recommend. And if you go to mexitplans.com/shop, you will see a link to this adapter. But this Ethernet kit is super important because it allows you to connect the satellite to the rest of your equipment and not just on Wi-Fi. So right now, if you only have the base kit, you're limited to Wi-Fi. And with these concrete walls in Mexico, it's very difficult to get this Wi-Fi signal beyond a room or two. So you would need to be able to connect this to a mesh network. Now, Starlink makes a mesh. I don't know anything about it. I have my own mesh network, which if you go to that link, you'll see it's the TP-Link Deco that I recommend and install for folks around town. But the being able to connect this to some other router, mesh, or whatever is super important. And so this Ethernet cable is almost mandatory if you're gonna order this Starlink kit. Here you can see I've plugged the router in. I've plugged it into the bottom as well. And when you do, you get a power light. So you get one single light in the middle that shows you that the router is powered. Now the router actually has a seal. It's designed to go indoors, but it actually has like a weatherproof seal as well as both of the connectors. So that's kind of nice. But once the router's plugged in, really, that's all you have to do for setup. The rest is actually done by the Starlink application. So we'll take a look at that right now.
So I had to move my satellite to my casita. So basically, I just want to show you kind of where I put it, right? So it is located up here on the roof of my casita. And I just, you know, basically set it there. That pretty much eliminates most of the obstructions because it has a clear view of the sky and it's doing well. So that's where the satellite's located.
All right, so here I am and I'm going to connect to the Starlink application so that we can finish setting this up. So let me go ahead and connect to Starlink. Now I've already activated my Starlink account because as I said a few weeks ago, I had an issue where my satellite was down or my internet was down. So I had to whip out the Starlink. And so I just went ahead and reconnected or reset up my satellite. Now this satellite has never been set up. This is the one that I just got back from Starlink. So I need to go in and actually set this up. So I'm gonna connect to the Starlink network. It is linked to my account online. So you start this whole process of getting Starlink in Mexico by going to starlink.com and just basically putting in your area and they'll tell you if it's available. So here I'm going to log into my Starlink account online. See if I can remember it. Oh, I just need to create a wire. So I'm gonna call this ATLian Starlink. So I am now connected to ATL Starlink and I'm going to select my dish. And I can see that my dish is starting up. It is not connected yet. So right now it is offline.
Basically, that's really all there is to it. Once you have it activated in your account and you go in and you set it up, you'll see that it's connected. You'll get two lines, one from the router to the satellite dish, and then another line showing that there's connectivity from the satellite dish up to the internet. One of the questions that I get asked an awful lot about Starlink is, since it's not in Mexico, right, it's in the sky, it's orbiting the Earth, and it's a US company, will you receive a US IP address? And the answer to that is no, you don't receive a US IP address. In fact, you actually get an IP address from Mexico. So if you're working remotely and you're supposed to be in the US, and you're using Starlink and you're supposed to be in the United States, it will look like you're working from Mexico. So what do I do? I have my personal VPN set up that I've created and I have a router located in Atlanta. And I'll demonstrate what that looks like once I use my personal VPN with the Starlink service. But for right now, I just wanna show you, I'm connected to my Starlink. It shows me connected and I'm gonna go ahead and run a speed test. If I had to come up with some detractors for Starlink, the first thing that I would say is probably the biggest is the upload speed. But right now with Starlink, I'm getting 231 megs up, 15 megs down, which is pretty good. And then on the Wi-Fi side, I'm getting 230 megs of internet speed from my phone, which is the device that's connected to the Starlink router. So I got 250 to the Starlink router. Now I'm in the room with the Starlink router, and the challenge with this is you have concrete walls in the house. So this is our guest room. This is the room where all of my networking equipment is located. So it's actually the best place in case I'm out. If my internet goes out, I can just plug this right into my mesh. And I'll show you what my mesh network looks like. In fact, let me flip over to that right now to show you what my mesh network looks like. So I have a bunch of Deco mesh access points, and there's a link to that on my website. This is what my network looks like. So you can see I have my main bedroom, living room, my daughter's room, the dining room, my nanny's room, and downstairs, which is this room that I'm in now, and the casita. And all of those points are directly connected because I've run cables directly to that mesh. So anywhere in my house, you get tremendous speed over my Telmex internet, which is fiber optics. Now, if my internet is down, which it has been more this year than any other year, I can simply just connect my Starlink out back, put it on top of the casita, run it into the house, and then with the Ethernet port, which I'm gonna show you right now, let me flip this over, because I wanna show you this Ethernet. Remember I talked about how important that was? With the Ethernet connected, let's see, which is this adapter that's on the floor here. Now this is an optional device. This does not come with the Starlink kit, so you have to buy this Ethernet adapter, and it connects from the satellite, which is this cable, and it goes into the router directly. Now, this is my personal VPN right here. So I'm using my other router, actually got toasted in an electrical storm. So I'm gonna use my 1300 and I'm gonna connect it to my Starlink so I can show you what that looks like. So this is the 1300. I'm gonna connect it to my Starlink via Ethernet. So I'm connecting it to the Ethernet there. And there is an ability in the Starlink to turn off the Wi-Fi if you have it connected to another router. All right, so I have my personal VPN connect, and we can see a couple of things here. So one, I am connected, but if I go to my VPN dashboard, I see that I'm no longer connected to my home VPN. So I'm gonna go ahead and enable that. So I'm gonna hit start, and that's gonna enable my personal VPN that's located in Atlanta. And now I'm connected in Atlanta. So if I go back over to whatismyipaddress.com, let me pull that up. Whatismyipaddress.com. Now you'll see that through my satellite, through my Starlink, connected to my personal VPN, that I am no longer in Mexico. So my IP address now shows up as one that is in Atlanta. So when you look at this, you'll see that I'm in Atlanta. And the cool thing about using this personal VPN over my Starlink is if I go to, you know, show complete IP details, it doesn't know that I'm using a VPN server. Like if you were using a public VPN service, it would absolutely say that you're probably using a VPN service or server. If you don't believe me, try it out using your VPN, your ExpressVPN, or whatever it is you have. Go to this site and see what it tells you. For more information on how to identify good internet in your home, check out this video over here. Until next time, Mexit Plans Monty, I'm out.